And I'm now going to mess about with weathering up a Shadespire Black Orc or Auroch or whatever they're called these days. You can see I've painted the armour and flesh and everything up already, and it's now just going to be, there's a few scratches and things on the armour that were modelled into it. It's now just going to be applying some weathering to make him look all dinged up. If I grab one of the existing ones, you can see how it looks at the end, hopefully. There's a bunch of scratches and messed up bits and whatnot all over the armour, so do that too. So I'll start off with a dark brown, dark grey, the dark grey sort of an off black. Mix the two of those together and that sort of does the very darkest of my corroded rusty patches. And it's roughly 50-50, but the joy of weathering, actually, it doesn't overly matter. All you want is something that is obviously different from the art. So, actually, I'm loading up a, can you see that? Utterly knackered brush. That was an old brush that had died, that then got the tips cut off and has been used for loads of dry brushing since. So got worn down and ruined. I'm going to use that and also a bit of the special weathering application tool, a bit of sponge. And it's as simple as to just, you can't even see any on there, so dunk it on until you get a bit on the end, and then I'm just going to knock the worst of that off because we don't want great big splodges, and then we can just touch that onto the armour. And you can see a knee pad there, and it just goes on in a very messy way. You can drag it slightly if you want it to streak a little. But kind of the point of this is it makes it all a little bit random and uncontrolled because you don't quite know where the paint is going to come off, because you're not, it's not like using a brush where you know exactly where the paint is on it. It naturally gives you much better, more random effect, which is kind of what you want here. Now, I am mostly sort of picking out around the edges and things, and because that is naturally where stuff will get chipped and bashed, but you do also want to just put a bit of sort of mud and dirty splatter across everything. And that's the advantage of this sort of dark brown grey mix. It makes a good base for rust, but it also works for just kind of looking, I don't know, just a bit of dirt, really. My palette's basically dried out, so I'll load a bit more onto it. Exact science of mixing the two together. I'm actually just going to rip the end off my sponge because I used that to pick it up out of the pot, so it'll now be totally saturated, which I don't want. Looks like it might be about right. Finger. There's actually a couple of nicks into the armour that I've never painted, so I should just get my AC mix. Put that right down in there. There you go, that can become a big broken up area. Similar there. I've missed off his front chest a bit. If the sponge is a bit too big and uncontrolled, I'll then use my stipply brush, but I want to catch just randomly across this, so let's just mess it up. absolutely detested the idea of doing weathering for ages, because carefully paint up a really nice controlled paint job and then set about trashing it. So yeah, as I say, onto my wrecked up stipple brush. Let's just go around the corner of this pad here. There you go, that gets... Yeah, this looks a bit too nice and clean still. There you go, that gives us a starter of some ball damage onto the armour. And as I say, that is just a mix of brown and dark grey so far. So, let's get that out of the way. Next up, I'm going to take my metallics, gunmetal grey, which is my sort of darker metal, and then I've got a bright silver. So, effectively, this is representing the fact this is painted armour, and when it's been bashed, it's just knocked the paint off. Ooh, I just sprayed. Sorry, when I closed my pot there, it sprayed out paint all over it. Hopefully I didn't get an oil. But yeah, when the armour gets hit, you're obviously going to ding the paint off the top of rivets and edges of things and sort of most prominent points. It's got this... It's just trying to represent that. And there you go, using my special removal tool there, the finger. There's no sort of exact basis for how I'm doing this. It's just as and where I think good, but normally anything that is a sharp edge you will catch. And excuse me. And if it knocks it right the way down to the metal, you'll get that showing through. So just around the edges of a few of these bits, bringing that up. And if you want, you can kind of use your sort of stipply brush again to just put some into the middle bits. I'm just using the tip of my brush because I'm being lazy. But if you want that sort of less controlled effect, again, the stippling is the way to go. Whilst I'm here, actually doing the metal rings, I never painted out. Big buckle. You can see I don't want anything that's too regular and even on here, so it's just touching it on in various places and pulling it around and things till you're happy, really. And back of his feet can be all scratched up. And I can put this on where I don't have any of the sort of brown rusty effect. That's just then a sort of fresh, clean, recent scrape. A bit of a funny one, just the fur and the armour don't have any clear definition between them there. So put a little bit around it out on the back of his neck. I didn't do any of the sort of muddiness, but the rustiness. I can go back and put that again after. There's no... doesn't really matter the sequence you do this in. Obviously, if I knock all my metal off, it'll not look a bit too much on the brush there. Not look quite as nice. I don't have the shine coming through it. Stipple around this where there's a big ding in it that spread the rust area out of just the main part. And then again, just coming back in with my metallic, gonna catch the edge of that, give it a bit of shine. Probably want this to go all the way up to silver. Chainmail anyway, it's just got a bit of the white onto it, so darken it down. Same on this side. Yeah, there we go. So now, you'd probably expect him to catch this on something at some point when he's trying to whack people, so let's go along there. Bright silver now. Yeah, once this thing runs out, I'll move over to the silver equivalent in the metal colour, but I just had this one before, so using up the last of it. It's perfectly good. Perfectly good silver paint, but I just like the way the, whatever they're called, the metal colour goes on. He's got a sort of spike on his elbow here, so that would catch up to the everything, so that wants to be quite bright. Yeah, apologies, got a bit of a cold at the moment, so hacking my lungs up every so often. So I ended up knocking most of my silver off here, so I'll just put a brighter line in on the edge of his armour. There's a bit in the middle of the chest I wanted to do, wasn't there? Suitably dinged up, catch the rivet. Assume that one has had the colour knocked off it. Same for these. I can never remember whether, I think it's meant to be silver above the metal gives you the best scars, but, what's it called? Scratches, that's what I'm after. But one of each there. Just made it silver up here, but I'll just catch the very edges. Right, there we go. So, and that is pretty much it. But what I will just drop on now is a bit of riser rust. I actually like to knock this down a little bit with the some of my brown colour, but still got a little bit on the palette there, so just mix that in till it gives me a, yeah, I've just managed to pull it into my silver, which is not what I wanted to do. Right, try that again. can see. It's sort of orangey brown rather than the pure bright orange. You probably see it when it goes on the model. And again, I'm not wanting a sort of precise line effect. So trash the end of my brush a little bit just to splay it out. And this gives me a spread of this rust effect. If you think about it, rust would get knocked off kind of the edges. So mostly sort of hitting away from the edge of the panels and more towards middly bits where you might have got a ding, but then it's just been left corroding down. But yeah, I reckon that'll do for me. That is weathering up a lovely set of armour. Enjoy.